we look here, we have an eye, and you can see the glistening part on the top. So this is the anterior. Every time you dissect, remember this is anatomy, you have to orient yourself. So the anterior is going to be here where the cornea is. Now the cornea should be clear, and it's not. So can you think of a reason why it's not clear? And we'll get back to that. So if this is the anterior portion, that means back over here is the posterior portion. And you can see there's a lot of fat around it. Fat is protective, and so this fat around the eye, which sits in the orbit, is called the periorbital fat. We're gonna go back here, and we're gonna try and find the optic nerve, because that's going to help us orient ourselves. And I may not be able to find it real easy. Let's see. Oh, there it is. So I've gone through all this fat, and you can see the structure trying to peek out right here. And that's going to be our optic nerve. And can you remember what cranial nerve that is? I'll give you a hint. You have two eyes to see with. So that should help you know which cranial nerve the optic nerve is. I'm going to pause this for a second because I'm going to take off some of this fat here. All right, so we can get a better view of the eye. All right, so we'll pause the video. You can see that the yellowish white is the fat, but I'm also cutting through some muscles. And if you've done the muscles already, you'll realize these are the muscles to the eye, and they're outside the eye, so they're called the extraocular muscles. And there's six of them, if you remember correctly. You may ask me which one is what, and I won't be able to tell you because I don't know where's the superior side of the orbit and where's the inferior side of the orbit because it's now outside the skull. So that doesn't help me any. So I'm taking this off a little bit so you can get a general idea of how small the eye really is. Look at all that fat. Protects the eye. Orient ourselves again. There's our optic nerve, so I know I haven't cut that. You say, how can I do this so fast? It's because I've done it before. And the other reason is because I know my anatomy. And the more you know your anatomy, the faster you can go. I think that's pretty good for right now. So I'm gonna move all this fat right here. I'm gonna actually put it off to the side so it doesn't get in the way. And we're back here at the beginning. So this is the cornea here. The thick outer part of the eye, I'll use my probe to point. This thick outer part here is usually what is white in a human, all right? So that is the sclera. Sclera means tough, all right? If we go back here again, here is the optic nerve. Here's a cornea. So we're going to cut this eye in a coronal view. And we're going to go maybe just a little bit less than a finger's breadth behind the cornea. So I have my knife here. And as a knife, always be careful. Always know where it is because that's the one part of the dissection where you can hurt yourself. So hold it firm in your non-dominant hand. And let's see if I can get into the sclera here. I'm cutting just a little bit behind the cornea. And actually, this is a little bit tough here, so I'm gonna put that knife back here. I'm gonna take my scissors, my smaller one I have here, and I'm gonna make a little cut with the scissors. All right, now I'm inside, I can actually go around with the scissors. See how I've done. I'm going to take a peek inside. I think I'm doing okay. Come all the way around, meet my other side, and we're going to split this out. All right, now you're going to see some jelly coming out. Oops, we're getting a little bit of the retina too. I don't want that yet. Now I'm going to pull that back this way in there, and I'm going to pull this out forward. All right. So you can see we're behind the lens. Again, this should be crystal clear, and it's not, so I'll let you think again, why is it not crystal clear? I would assume a cow can see. So there's a reason for this. And you can see this gelatinous-like material. So if we're behind the lens, we're in a certain cavity. And it's behind the lens, so the obvious name would be posterior. So we're sitting in the posterior cavity. So this gelatinous stuff right here is the vitreous humor. And you make vitreous humor when you're in your mom's uterus, and it stays with you your whole life. All right? And that is crystal clear too. And it helps maintain the shape of the eye. So we're gonna take that out because he's interfering with what we're gonna look at next. And we're gonna come back to this posterior cavity in a little bit. So let's go back over here to the anterior cavity. All right, so if we can take off some of that vitreous humor, we can look at the posterior surface of the lens and see what we can see here. Now, some of that may be water from the anterior cavity, and that water is the aqueous humor, which sits in the anterior cavity. So if you look right here at the lens, we might get a vision of what the suspensory ligaments look like. They're really hard to see and they're crystal clear. Let's see if we can see them. They'll look like little, stop it for a second. I need a paper towel. I grabbed a paper towel in that time just to soak up some of this moisture here to see if we can get a good view. So if we pull that lens apart, sometimes you'll see the little, there they are. You probably miss them, and I'll probably rip them here, but I'm gonna flip it forward and you'll see these little tiny, clearish looking ligaments right there when I pull it apart. Those are your suspensory ligaments. And if you remember, your suspensory ligaments attach to the ciliary body. So this right here is your ciliary body. The ciliary body is going to attach to the aura serrata, which is here, which will have attached to the retina, which we'll see again on the posterior cavity. So again, the lens, which always reminds me of a Super Bowl. All right, the suspensory ligaments are these little things right here. All right, and then the ciliary body, and then here at this edge is the aura serrata. We're gonna pull that lens out. Oops, there goes the ciliary suspensory ligaments. You see right there, I'm gonna pop those suspensory ligaments. Pop, 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 pop. You can see a few left. And we can get back here. Now you see the cornea again. Cornea is the clear part. The hole is a pupil. So making that hole is the iris. So this part right here is the iris. And if we look really, really close, we might be able to see the two muscles that make up the iris. Let's flip it inside out like that. Let's see what we can see. All right, yes we can. So the iris has composed of a sphincter muscle that is the internal one, that's this one right here. And if you notice the fibers are going around. So this is the pupil constrictor muscle because when it constricts, when it contracts, it will make the pupil smaller. And that is controlled by part of the autonomic system. Which part do you think it is? And then if you look here, this is the other muscle, little fibers are going in this direction. This is a pupil dilator muscle, all right? That will make the pupil bigger, help dilate the pupil. And you can think about which part of the sympathetic, whoops, I just told you the answer, which part of the nervous system that belongs to. All right, so all this would have been in the anterior cavity. So to look one more time, this hole would be called the, right? The covering on the outside would be called the, all right? This muscle right here, the internal one would be, the one that's on the outer part would be, this muscle right here that connects to the lens would be, and then this little serrated structure at the end would be what? All right, and then there's a fluid that's in that cavity. You could tell me that too. Last is the lens, right? And there's actually a little bit of that suspensory ligament still attached to it. So let's move to the posterior cavity. All right, we'll get rid of some of that fluid. I'll take my little trusty paper towel here. And my retina became a little bit detached when I cut the eye open. But the retina is the internal layer, and that is this beige layer right here. And if I scoop up that entire beige layer, the retina has all your photoreceptors, remember? And there are two photoreceptors, you can name those two. And if we scoop that all up, you'll see that all those neurons, all those fibers that you cannot see that make up this whole retina, exit the eye on the posterior side right there. And this structure right here has a name, that structure where they exit. It is called the optic disc. And in your vision, it's known as a blind spot. So if we take that, the optic disc, what do you think it ends up being? Well, if we flip that over and watch, it's right where the optic nerve would be. So if we follow that nerve all the way back down in, we would get to the optic disc. Now you notice there's some, and the pretty layer underneath that retina here, and it's sort of this blue-green color. We don't have this. This layer that's blue-green right here does not exist in us. It's called the tapetum lucidum, and it exists in many animals, including if you have a cat, because what it allows is it allows the light to reflect back and forth in the posterior cavity, so this retina gets stimulated more. And when do you think you need light more often? When do you have trouble seeing? Maybe it's in the dark. So you may notice that a cat's eyes glow in the dark. That's because of the light reflecting off of this tapetum lucidum. Unfortunately, we don't have that layer, so we don't see very well in the dark. And you'll look next, the black layer is a choroid. Choroid, C-H-O-R-I-O-D. The choroid is a vascular layer. And if we take that layer off, right there, we're going to get back to the sclera. And there's that tough sclera layer, which in us would be white in color. You can see it's very tough. I can hold the whole eye up with it. So we go over this again. The fluid we took out was the, let me know, the beige layer, which is the most inner layer, was the, if we took all those beige fibers, they exit right here, which is the, this colored layer is the, and the black layer is the, and last, the white layer is what? Okay, once you've done all that, you have done a great job in dissecting the eye. Take care of making sure disposing upon all your materials properly into the correct bag, and then they can go in the trash in an opaque bag. All right.